أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط صدق الله العظيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا اليهود والنصارى أولياء بعضهم أولياء بعض ومن يتولهم منكم فإنه منهم ان اللہ لا یهدی القوم الظالمین صدق اللہ العظیم. رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی. بیفور آئی پروسیڈ فردر لیٹ می ایکسپلین ٹو تھنگز ریگارڈنگ مائی لاسٹ لیکچر. آئی ڈیڈ اپالوجائز ٹو دی یمنی بردر دیٹ آئی گیو دوز ریمارکس. I want to add to it that things are not confined to any particular race or country. I must admit that now these days the most notorious people in Saudi Arabia are the Pakistanis, and I belong to Pakistan, so we must accept the facts. But you know, a country like Yemen, because they didn't have oil, they were poor people, they worked very hard in Saudi Arabia, and they were a very persecuted lot. Among them there were some you know, wrong type of people also. But it was just said in those days, about 20 years back, when I performed my first Hajj in 1962. At that time it was a general saying in Saudi Arabia that among the Yemenis there are thieves. So that came to my mind and I just said those words. Second thing which I want to explain is that we have heard and we have read three very stern pronouncements of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. And I said that if you look to the Muslims of today, most of us, they come under the, you know, this judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What's the way out? What can you do? What can I do? How to absolve ourselves of this big charge? Well, I can't change the whole nation, the whole country. So what to do? So there must be some way out. The way out is there. If we decide that we shall all our life, we shall devote our energies primarily to changing this system and establish Islam, then personally it will be a kafara for us. We have not reconciled with the system. We are not cooperating with the system. We are not after money and property and so on and so forth. If we are devoting all our energies, capabilities, all time, except for the little that we need for only subsistence, you know, in this world. You need something to eat. You need some roof over your heads. But the minimum subsistence level, we spend our time and money and capabilities only to that level, subsistence level, minimum, and reserve the energies and time and capabilities and everything to establish the deen of Allah, then personally we shall be absolved. This will become a kafara for us. That is the way out. Now let us proceed further. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا اليهود والنصارى أولياء. O you who believe, don't take the Jews and the Christians as friends. This is a very categorical statement. You can have business relations, you can have good social relations, but friendship is something else. That's why I told you, خُلَّ وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. And the Prophet says, لَوْ كُنْتُ مُتَّخِذًا خَلِيلًا لَتَّخَذْتُ أَبَا بَكْرٍ خَلِيلًا. In the same way, awliya, protector, real friends on whom you depend. And this is categorical. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّخِذُوا الْيَهُودَ وَالنَّصَارَى أَوْلِيَا. بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَا وَبَعْضُ. They are friends to each other. They are protectors to each other. Now about these words, recently it came to my mind that actually when Quran was being revealed, this was not the condition. They were not friends to each other. They have been the Jews and the Christians throughout history. They have been bittermost enemies to each other. Then why is Quran saying this? Wherever the Christians had the authority and power, they persecuted the Jews. Wherever the Jews came into power, even you know about half a century before the advent of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so many Christians were burnt alive in Yemen by Abu Nawas, a Jew king. You know, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَعُودِ وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودِ قُتِلَ أَصْحَابُ الْأُخْدُودِ النَّارِ ذَاتِ الْوَقُودِ إِذْ هُمْ عَلَيْهَا قُعُودٌ وَهُمْ عَلَى مَا يَفْعَلُونَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ الشُّهُودِ. To which incident these ayat relate? So they have been bittermost enemies to each other. It was actually a prophecy for this time which was going to come. Jews slowly and slowly eroded the Christian society, entered it from the back door, like viruses. First of all, they divided them into Protestants and Catholics. Then they used the Protestants, you know, they roared over them. The WASP, white Anglo-Saxon Protestants, they became the tools in the hands of the Jews. And now recently they have conquered the Catholicism also. When they could extract from the Pope the verdict that these Jews are not responsible for the crucifixion of Jesus. And now, you know, Vatican has recognized Israel. And the embassy of Vatican is going to be established in Jerusalem. And Pope is going to visit Jerusalem. Isaac Rabin, he requested Pope when he was coming back from Washington, going back, I should say from here, going back from Washington to Tel Aviv, and he stopped over in Rome and had an audience with the Pope, and he got a promise that I will come and visit. Now they have conquered. But still they are not friends actually. Jews have conquered them. They are riding them. So this is the condition. But now they are helping each other. For United States of America, safety of Israel is priority number one in everything. Foreign policy, economic policy, everything. Priority number one, and they say it openly now. Now they don't fear to say it and proclaim it. Because after the demise of USSR, now because they are the sole supreme power on earth, they don't fear to say it out openly. So this is the condition which has happened today. These words were prophetic words of prophecy and denoting to our times. Otherwise at the time of the Prophet they were not friends to each other. And they were not friends to each other at least for 1,000 years after that. It was after the rise of Protestantism in Europe that they, you know, started controlling. وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّهُمْ مِنْكُمْ And whosoever from amongst you makes friends with them, فَإِنَّهُ مِنْهُمْ He is also from among them. Very stern warning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is happening today in the Arab world? I need not say anything. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِ الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ Verily Allah is not going to guide such evildoers. فَتَرَى الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ يُسَارِعُونَ فِيهِمْ Now coming back to the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Again a mention is being made of the hypocrites, the munafiqeen. تَرَى الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ You will see those people who have a disease in their hearts. These words denote nifaq. فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا وَلَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ In the very second section of Surah Al-Baqarah. فَتَرَى الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ يُسَارِعُونَ فِيهِمْ They are running about in them, moving about in them. They want to please them, keep them pleased. The munafiqeen, they wanted to keep them pleased, the Jews. يَقُولُونَ نَخْشَىٰ أَن تُصِيبَنَا دَائِرَةٌ If somebody asks them, what are you doing? Why are you going so close to them? Why do you meet them so often? Why are you seen so often in their company? What was the reply? يَقُولُونَ نَخْشَىٰ أَن تُصِيبَنَا دَائِرَةٌ We fear that any turn of event may prove disastrous for us. As I said yesterday, last night, we can't keep all the eggs in one basket. We have to keep some good offices with these people, but God knows, maybe they get the upper hand. What shall we do then? This is their character. فَعَسَ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَاتِيَ بِالْفَتْحِ So, maybe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings victory for the Muslims. أَوْ أَمْرٍ مِّنْ إِنْدِهِ Or another some commandment comes from him. فَيُصْبِحُ عَلَىٰ مَا أَصَرُّ فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ نَادِمِينَ And then these people will have to repent and be remorseful and they will have to regret on what they had in their hearts. وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا And then the true moments will say, أَهَوْلَا الَّذِينَ أَقْسَمُوا بِاللَّهِ جَعَدْ آيَمَانِ Are these the people who were swearing as much as they could? إِنَّهُمْ مِنْكُمْ That they are with us. But we know when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has exposed them, they will wonder, oh, these people, they were munafiqs. We taught them to be Muslims, Mu'mins, and they always swore by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by God, we are with you. Trust us. حَبِتَ تَعْمَالُمْ All their good deeds have gone in vain. They have been praying behind Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the mosque, where one salah gives the reward of 50,000. But you know, only for the mu'min, not for the munafiq. All their deeds will go in vain. فَأَصْبَحُوا خَاسِرِينَ And they will be the losers, the biggest losers. Now come a set of three ayat, which are amongst the most important ayat of the Quran. And here we shall find the word irtidad. What is irtidad? Radda, yaruddo, to turn somebody else. Turn him away, turn that away. Irtidad, to turn yourself back. Irtidad. And irtidad is also a legal thing and a hidden thing. As I told you, real iman versus legal iman. A munafiq is legally a mu'min, but really a kafir. So real iman versus legal iman. Real nifaq, real kufr versus legal kufr. And now, third category, real irtidad and legal irtidad. Legally a person is murtad when he openly says, I'm not a Muslim now. Converts to Christianity or to any other religion, he becomes a Hindu or both. Or also. He declares it. He is a legal murtad. But somebody is hiding in him. He has become kafir. But he doesn't want to declare. Just as the munafiq. ان الذين امنوا ثم كفروا ثم امنوا ثم كفروا ثم ازدادوا كفرا. They had become kafirs. They were murtad, but not legal murtad. Murtad within. And same is the case of a person, please note, who joins the party of Allah, Hizbullah. He says, I devote myself for Allah and His deen. And when there are difficulties and tests and tribulations, he starts retracting his steps, going back, going to the rear, shading into the background. This is irtidad. But this is essential irtidad, not legal irtidad. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu may yartadda minkum an deenihi. Oh, you who believe, be warned. Whosoever amongst you will retrace his steps from iman, real iman, to real kufr, remaining a legal Muslim all the time, فَسَوْفَ يَعْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ. So Allah doesn't care about them. Allah doesn't care about you. Allah will bring another people. يَعْتِ اللَّهُ بِقَوْمٍ يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَهُ. Allah will bring in your place another nation, another community, whom He will love and they will love Him. It's a mutual bond of love between Allah and His servants and bondsmen. أَذِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. They will be very lenient and humble to the Muslims. A'izzatin alal kafirin. And stern and firm against the kuffar, against the disbelievers. Yujahiduna fi sabilillah. And they will make jihad in the way of Allah. Wala yakhafuna lawmat allaim. And they will never fear or never care for the reproach of any reproacher. This reproach is also friendly sometimes. What has happened to you? You are not looking after your family correctly. You are devoting your time more to your party. You are not looking after your family. You are spending in the way of Allah, going on, going on. You are not keeping something with you for bad days to come. This reproach can be friendly. واپس نہیں پھیرا کوئی فرمان جنو کا تنہا نہیں لوٹی کبھی آواز جرس کی خیریت جان راحت تن صحت داما سب بھول گئی مصلحت اہل حوث کی اس راہ میں جو سب پہ گزرتی ہے سو گزری تنہا پس زندہ کبھی رسوا سر بازار کڑکے ہے بہت شیخ سر گوشہ ممبر گرجے ہے بہت اہل حکم بر سر دربار چھوڑا نہیں غیروں نے کوئی ناوی کے دشنام اور چھوٹی نہیں اپنوں سے کوئی طرز ملامت اس عشق نہ اس عشق پہ نادم ہے مگر دل ہر داغ ہے اس دل میں بجز داغ ندامت. A true mu'min, he devotes himself, he invests himself, he doesn't care for his career, for his business. People will say he's a fool. Anomino kama amana sufaha. Should we also become like these fools? They don't have any thought about their future. They are not mindful of their benefits and interests. They are crazy. They are fanatics. Well, Allah loves such fanatics. يا أيها الذين آمنوا من يرتد منكم عن دينه فسوف يأتي الله بقوم يحبهم ويحبونه. Three dimensions. May Allah give us this character. But there are three constituent aspects of this character. A mutual love between Allah and you. يحبهم ويحبونه. Allah loves them and they love him. أذلة على المؤمنين عزة على الكافرين. Tough on the unbelievers and very lenient and humble towards the believers. Yujahiduna fi sabilillah. Third dimension. They are exerting and devoting everything for the cause of Allah, to make the deen of Allah supreme. And they are not caring for any reproacher. He is reproaching either in an opposing way or in an advising way. ذَٰلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُوتِيَ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. And this is the bounty of Allah. He gives to whomsoever He pleases. May Allah include us in them. وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ. And don't think the prayers of the bounty of Allah are not limited. All resourceful. He is all resourceful. And He knows everything. He knows who is worthy of this bounty. He doesn't throw it. His bounty is not to be thrown away. He knows who is worthy to have it. إِنَّمَا وَلِيُّكُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Again, three things. You must take Allah as your wali, number one. Your protector, your friend. وَرَسُولَهُ, number two, and His messenger. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And number three, those who have faith, who believe. And what is the character of those? Again, three things. Three dimensions of the character. يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَهُ. عِزَّةٍ عَلَى الْكَافِرِينَ أَذِلَّةٍ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. يُجَاهِدُونَ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلَا يَخَافُونَ لَوْمَةَ لَائِمٍ. Three dimensions of the character of a Muslim whom Allah loves. Three friends for you. Allah number one, His messenger number two, and Ahle Iman. And what are those Ahle Iman? How do you identify them? الَّذِينَ يُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ. Who establish regular prayer, وَيُوتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ. And they pay the obligatory charity, وَهُمْ رَاكِعُونَ. Most of the people have misunderstood this point, رَاكِعُونَ, and they keep bowing. What do you mean by bowing? When they give their alms, they give with humility. Not they think that, oh, I am superior to you, I am giving to you this charity. In humility. Because we have read in Surah Al-Baqarah that this sadaqat and this infaq, the first priority should be to those people who have devoted all their time to the service of deen. They don't have time now to earn their livelihood. You should look after them. And such people will not beg you. لا يسألون الناس إلحافا. They are not going to beg you. You will have to find them and you will have to request, please accept this thing from me. I know you have devoted your time for the deen of Allah. You don't have time to earn your livelihood. I want to share. But please accept. So that is وَيُوتُونَ الزَّكَاةَ وَهُمْ رَاكِعُونَ. Not arrogantly. وَمَّنْ يَتَوَلَّ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Whosoever passed this test, that his friendship is number one for Allah, and number two for Rasul, and number three for Ahli Iman, فَإِنَّ حِزْبَ اللَّهِ هُمُ الْغَالِبُونَ. Then such a party of Allah will triumph, inshallah. But if you keep in view your blood relations and your friendships and your business relations and so on and so forth, this should be your priorities. Allah, Rasul, and Ahle Iman. And those Ahle Iman, not the munafiqs, real Ahle Iman. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتخذوا الذين اتخذوا دينكم هزوا ولعبا من الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم والكفار أولياء. Oh, you who believe, don't take those people, either they are from the mushrikeen, kuffar, or from those who were given the book before. Don't take them as friends if they mock at your deen. Gariban, make it a plain thing. They used to, you know, laugh at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to mock at the deen. Oh, now such a ayat has come. Oh, now they are laughing. And they were, who are they? They were the Jews doing it. But people who were friends to them, they were sitting in that company. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forbidding them. لا تتخذون أولياء. فاتقوا الله إن كنتم مؤمنين. Fear Allah. Have His regard if you are real moments. You should not be tolerant, so to say, to all this type of things. When you call for prayer, when you give adhan, well, they laugh at it. What are they doing? They mock at it. They make it a piece of playing. ذَلَكَ بِأَنَّهُ قَوْمٌ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. And this is because they don't have the real knowledge. قُلْ يَا عَلَى الْكِتَابِ. Say to them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O people of the book, هَلْ تَنْقِمُونَ مِنَّا إِلَّا أَنْ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْنَا وَمَا أُنزِلَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. Are you hostile to us and full of revenge against us only because we believe in Allah? And we believe also in what has been sent down to us. And we believe also in what was sent down to you. وَإِنَّ أَكْسَرَكُمْ فَاسِقُونَ. Verily, most of you, أَكْسَر, majority of you, most of you, they are the transgressors. قُلْ هَلْ أُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِشَرٍ مِّنْ ذَلِكَ مَصُوبَةً عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. Say to them, should I tell you what is more bad than this, worse than this? As a remorse, as a retribution from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, recompense. What is that? Man la'anahullah, whom Allah has cursed, wa ghazib alayhi, and his wrath has come down on him, wa ja'ala minhumul qiradata wal khanazira. And he transformed some of them into apes, turned them into monkeys and swine. وَعَبَدَ الطَّاغُوتِ. And they became subservient bondsmen to Tahut, those who are in rebellion against Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ شَرٌّ مَكَانًا وَضَلُّ عَنْ سَبَعِ السَّبِيلِ. They are much worse in position and rank, and they are the most far away, farthest away, they are the farthest away from the straight path. وَإِذَا جَاكُمْ قَالُوا آمَنَّا. And when now they come to you, O Muslims, that was their behavior in the company of the Jews. Now when they come to you, O Muslims, قَالُوا آمَنَّا. They say, we also believe, we are with you, we have the faith. وَقَدْ دَخَلُوا بِالْكُفْرِ وَهُمْ قَدْ خَرَجُوا بِهِ. Although reality is that when they entered with kufr. And when they went away with kufr. They never tasted the taste of iman. Even when they came in your company, maybe they spent an hour with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even that didn't benefit him. He came, he entered with kufr, went out with kufr. وَقَيَاتِ جَاءُوا قَالُوا آمَنَّا وَقَدْ دَخَلُوا بِالْكُفْرِ وَهُمْ قَدْ خَرَجُوا بِهِ وَاللَّهُ عَلَمُ بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْتُمُونَ. And Allah is very much aware of what they are hiding. وَتَرَى كَثِيرًا مِّنْهُمْ يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْإِسْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ وَقْلِهُمُ السُّوءِ. And you will see many of them running about, striving for what? For sin and transgression, and eating haram, devouring haram, consuming what is unlawful. لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Very bad and evil what they are doing. لَوْلَا يَنْهَاهُمُ الرَّبَّانِيُّونَ وَالْأَحْبَارُ عَنْ قَوْلِهُمُ الْإِسْمَ وَأَكْلِهِمُ السُّحْتَ. Now this is another dimension of the decay of a society, of a Muslim society. Who were the Jews? They were the Muslims of the past. Weren't they? They were the former Muslim Ummah. وَأَنِّي فَضَّلْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْعَالَمِينَ. When a Muslim society goes down, decays, one of the signs and symptoms of the disease is that the spiritual and religious leaders, they stop doing their duty. Their duty is to enjoin whatever is correct and right and to forbid from whatever is wrong. If they claim to be leaders, If they claim to be knowledgeable in deen, if they claim to have some purification of souls and spirits, this is their first duty. لَوْلَا يَنْهَاهُمُ الرَّبَّانِيُونَ. Why are their rabbis not forbidding them? They are taking money from them and that's all else. Balahbar, and their ulama, their jurists, their fuqaha, they should have forbidden them. لَوْلَا يَنْهَاهُمُ الرَّبَّانِيُّونَ وَالْأَحْبَارُ أَنْ قَالِهِمُ الْإِسْمَ وَأَكْلِهِمُ السُّحْتَ. Why didn't they forbid them from saying, uttering of sin, and devouring and consuming what is unlawful? لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَصْنَعُونَ. It's very bad and evil what they are doing, what are they making. But they are preparing for their own future of the hereafter. وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةٌ. And the Jews say, Allah's hands have been tied up. Why did they say this? For us, there is no good for Allah now. For us, there is no good with Allah. He has deposed us, and he has given this position to Muslims. يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةٌ. His hands are tied up now. In another sense, they used to say, when Allah says, أَقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا, he is poor, we are rich, نَحْنُ أَغْنِيَاءُ, اللَّهُ فَقِيرٌ وَنَحْنُ أَغْنِيَاءُ. So these are the utterances. قَالِهُمُ الْإِسْمُ وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودُ يَدُ اللَّهِ مَغْلُولَةٌ غُلَّتْ أَيْدِيهِمْ. Actually, their hands have been tied up. They have been withheld from accepting the real faith and real deen. Their way to real path has been obstructed. لُعِنُوا بِمَا قَالُوا. And they have been cursed for what they have been saying. بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوتَتَانِ يُنْفِقُ كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ. While Allah's both hands are outstretched, he spends whatever he wishes. وَلَيَزِيدَنَّ كَثِيرًا مِّنْهُمْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ طُغْيَانًا وَكُفْرًا. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whatever he has sent down to you, O Muslims, it is adding up and it will go on adding up in these Jews, the rebellion as well as blasphemy. The more Allah is giving you, the more they are jealous. Their heart burning is increasing. The more they are going against Allah and His Messenger, the more Allah is blessing you. The farther away they go from the blessings of Allah. وَأَلْقَيْنَا بَيْنَهُمُ الْعَذَابَةَ وَالْبَغْضَاءَ إِلَىٰ يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ. And we have put or cast between them enmity and hatred till the day of resurrection. كُلَّمَا أَوْقَدُوا نَارًا لِلْحَرْبِ أَطْفَأَ اللَّهِ. Whenever they try to kindle a fire for war, what does it mean? The Jews in the Medina, they always conspired and they always encouraged the Makki Mushrikeen to come and invade. We shall help. We shall help you from within. You come and invade. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most of the times, when they wanted to kindle the fire of war, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extinguished it. Atfa Allah. وَيَسْعَوْنَ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَسَادًا. And they are trying to create mischief in the land. وَاللَّهُ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُفْسَدِينَ. And verily Allah doesn't like such mischief mongers. وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ آمَنُوا وَاتَّقَوْا. And had these people of the book believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and in this Quran, وَاتَّقَوْا, and had they taken to taqwa, لَكَفَّرْنَا عَنْهُمْ, we would have blotted out from them. لَكَفَّرْنَا عَنْهُمْ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ, all their evil deeds. وَلَأَدْخَلْنَاهُمْ جَنَّاتِ النَّعِيمِ. And we would have made them enter, admitted them to the gardens of bliss. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ أَقَامُوا التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ. Now another very important term of Quran. Acting upon Quran, acting upon the book of Allah. The first term, you know, that was discussed in thrice or four times or five times in one section. حُكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ أَنِحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْكُمْ. You have to decide and judge according to what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent down. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَاسِقُونَ. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْكَافِرُونَ. وَمَنْ لَمْ يَحْكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ. The other one is إِقَامَةُ مَا أُنزِلَ مِنَ اللَّهِ. Whatever Allah has sent down, establish it. This is as a system. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you as his deen is actually a political, socio-economic system based on justice. At individual level, حُكُمْ بِمَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهِ. At collective level, at social level, at the level of the state and society, إِقَامَةُ مَا أُنزِلَ مِنَ اللَّهِ. To establish whatever has been sent down by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which we, in our case, is called إِقَامَةُ الدِّينِ. أَنْ أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. And what does إِقَامَةُ الدِّينِ means? إِقَامَةُ of Quran. All the rules and laws, all the do's and don'ts of Quran, establish them in a wholesome way, as they are organic whole, not part of it. أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضٍ فَمَا جَزَاءُ مَنْ يَفْعَلُ ذَلِكَ مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا خِزْيٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ أَشَدِّ الْعَذَابِ. Not that. Whole of it. So now you read these words. وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ أَقَامُوا التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ. Had they established Torah and Injil, وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ, and whatever was sent down to them from their Lord. Because you know, وَهِي continued to come to other prophets also. Torah and Injil. And we have so many books. Books of Yasriya and books of Fala, such and such Nabi in the Old Testament. وَمَعُنْدِ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبِّهِمْ. If they had established it, لَأَكَلُوا مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَمِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلَيْهِمْ. They would have eaten from their, over their heads also, and from underneath their feet also. What does it mean? The sky would have poured down all the barakat, all the blessings, and the earth would have brought out all its hidden treasures for them. These barakat, these blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would have come to them. Had they established the deen of Allah, the book of Allah, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ أَقَامُوا التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ وَمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْهِمْ مِنْ رَبِّهِمْ لَأَكَلُوا مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ وَمِنْ تَحْتِ أَرْجُلِهِمْ مِنْهُمْ أُمَّةٌ مُقْتَصِدَةٌ. Among them, there is some group which is moderate and just. Few people are there. It's not that all the Jews had gone that way. But again, the same saying in Arabic, hukmul aksare hukmul kul. When the majority goes that way, it means the whole nation is gone. But in all, even in the worst times, some individuals remain. As Allama Iqbal says, you know, خال خال اس قوم میں اب تک نظر آتے ہیں وہ کرتے ہیں اشک سحرگاہی سے جو ظالم وضو. Even in the Muslim Ummah today, there are individuals, very pious people, very good-hearted people. But what percentage of this Ummah is of that type? The majority has gone very far off. منهم امت مقتصدہ وکثیر منهم ساء ما يعملون. Many among them, the majority of them, it's very evil what they are doing. Ya ayyuha rasul balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbika. Oh messenger of Allah, convey whatever has been sent down to you from your Lord. You can't conceal even one ayah. You know, Quran contains even those ayat in which there was admonition for the Prophet himself. لِمَا تُحَرِّمُ مَا أَحْلَ اللَّهُ لَكَ. Was it a very pleasant sentence for the Prophet? عَبَسَ وَتَوَلَّا أَنْ جَاهُ الْعَمَى وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّهُ يَذَّكَّى أَوْ يَذَّكَّرُ فَتَنْفَعُهُ الذِّكْرَى أَمَّا مَنْ اسْتَغْنَى فَأَنْتَ لَهُ تَصَدَّى وَأَمَّا مَنْ جَاءَكَ يَسْعَى وَهُوَ يَخْشَى فَأَنْتَ عَنْهُ تَلَهَى. Was this very pleasant for the present, for the Prophet? But even these had to be conveyed. Even these had to be preserved in the Quran. On no account can you keep anything away, can you hide anything. Ya ayyuha rasul, balligh ma unzila ilayka min rabbik. Wa illam taf'al fama ballaghta risalata. And if you fail to do it, then you would not have fulfilled your duties as messenger of Allah. Wallahu yasimuka minan nas. And don't fear people. Allah will protect you. You may be tempted to hide something from the people lest they get offended. Don't fear them. Wallahu yasimuka minan nas. Allah will protect you. He guarantees your protection. Inna Allah la yadil qawmul kafirin. And Allah is not going to lead such thankless people towards the right path. Again the same term. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لَسْتُمْ عَلَى شَيْنْ حَتَّى تُقِيمُ التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلَ وَمَا أُنْزِلَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Tell them, O people of the book, you stand on nothing unless you establish Torah and Injil and whatever was sent down to you. But please, read this very ayah in another form also. يَا أَهْلَ الْقُرَانِ لَسْتُمْ عَلَى شَيْنْ حَتَّى تُقِيمُ الْقُرَانِ. Allah doesn't weigh with different weights for different peoples. His weights are the same. His rules are the same. لَن تَجَدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَحْوِيلًا وَلَن تَجَدَ لِسُنَّةِ اللَّهِ تَبْدِيلًا. Same values, the same standards, the same criterion. You are asking me, you are calling me, you are praying me, you are asking my mercy. لَسْتُ مَلَا شَيْهَتَّى تُقِيمُ الْقُرَانِ. You have no face to talk to me. Unless you establish Quran. That's why we go on praying and praying and praying, even Qunut and Adhula, for days and days and days and days. But what happened to so many Arab countries in 1967? It happened. What happened to Pakistan in 1971? It happened. People crying, O Allah, Ya Allah. Allah doesn't listen. Lastu malashe. You don't have any face to address us. Who are you? O Ya Ahlul Kitab, lastu malashe in hatta tuqimu Torata wal Injil wa ma unzila ilaykum min rabbikum. Wa la yazidanna kaseeran minhum ma unzila ilaykum min rabbika tughyanan wa kufra. Again the same verse. What bounty is coming to you, O Muslims? It is making these Yahud and Nasara, whom the book was given before, more arrogant, more rebellious. فَلَا تَعْسَ عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. But you don't feel grieved about this. Well, they will have to reap what they are sowing. And they are reaping what they sowed. So you don't feel sorry for them. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا وَالصَّابِعُونَ وَالنَّصَارَى مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. This is nearly exactly the same ayah as came in the 8th section of Surah Al-Baqarah, which is usually misinterpreted. Only one thing is to be added. Verily those who have come to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ هَادُوا, and also those who became Jews, وَالصَّابِعُونَ, and also the Sabis. It is said that they were the followers of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam. وَالنَّصَارَى, and Christians. مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرَةِ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا. Whosoever had real faith in Allah and the last day, and whosoever was doing good deeds in his own times. You add these words, these are implied here. Till such time that Hazrat Masih didn't come, well, those people who were acting about Torah, who believed in Moses, who believed in Allah, who believed in the last day, well, they were okay. فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Their rewards are preserved, ensured. And now when Jesus came, Now, whosoever becomes a Christian, he accepted Jesus also. Now, if he believes in Allah also, and he believes in the day, last day also, and he is doing good deeds, well, his salvation is ensured. But now when Muhammad has come, whosoever has believed in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, accepted him, and but he must have iman in Allah, faith in the last day, and must do good deeds. Not only because you believe to Muslim Ummah, your salvation is ensured. Not even at that time, before Jesus, because you believe to the race of Jews, it doesn't mean that you have the salvation for you. Iman billah, iman bil akhirah, and the Rasul, the messenger of that time. Three things, and then you know, good deeds. لَقَدْ أَخَذْنَا مِيثَاقَ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ وَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهِمْ رُسُلًا. We had taken the covenant from Bani Israel. Again, that surah of covenant I told you. وَأَرْسَلْنَا إِلَيْهِمْ رُسُلًا, and we sent to them so many messengers. I told you the chain of prophets didn't break for 1400 long years in that former Muslim Ummah. From the time of Moses till the time of Jesus. Then was the first break of 600 years. Ala fatratin min ar-rusul. Today we have read those words. This was the gap. Otherwise, from Moses till Jesus, 1400 years, no gap. Kullama ja'ahum rasulun bima la tahwa anfusahum. But what had been the attitude of the Jews? Whenever a rasul came to them with what didn't please them. When there's the rasul and he says Allah says so, and they didn't like it. Fariqan kazzabu. Some of them they belied. Oh, you are wrong. But fariqan yaqtulun. And they used to kill so many. They killed John the Baptist. They killed Zechariah. And who killed? Who was the king at that time? You. Yahya alayhi salatu wasalam was murdered at the order of that king, Jew king. Why? The king was very much pleased with the dancing of the daughter of his own wife. But he wanted to have this daughter also in his marriage. And he was very much pleased with him. She danced and he liked. And then the daughter said, I want the head of. He said, whatever you want, I'll fulfill your anything that you want, desire, any desire. She said, I want the head of John, because Hazrat Yahya used to criticize him. Him as well as the mother of that girl. That is why he was killed. Fariqan kazzabu wa fariqan yaqtulun. Wahasibu Allah takuna fitnatun. They thought that there is not going to be any trial for them. We are the chosen people of the Lord. No harm could come to us. Fa'amu wa sammu. They became blind and deaf. Blind to all realities, deaf to every message of truth from any prophet or messenger. They became blind and deaf. Summa taba Allahu alayhim. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept on forgiving them. Summa amu wa sammu kaseerun minhum. But instead of mending their ways, they became more and more blind and more and more deaf. Wallahu basirun bima ya'malun. And Allah is seeing and watching what they are doing. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. These words appeared before also. Verily, those people have blasphemed. They have uttered blasphemy. They have committed kufr. When they said, إِنَّ اللَّهُ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. Allah himself has come down on earth in the form of Masih ibn Maryam. God incarnate. Just as Hindus have the ideas, Ramchandra was a God incarnate, Krishna is God incarnate. So that was the concept of many Christians. وَقَالَ الْمَسِيحِ Although Jesus himself had said, يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عُبُدُ اللَّهِ رَبِّي وَرَبَّكُمْ O children of Israel, worship Allah, who is my Lord as well as your Lord. إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ Verily, whosoever commits shirk with Allah, declares someone to be equal to Allah, to be associate with Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made the garden of Jannah forbidden for him, out of bounds for them. وَمَا وَاهُ النَّارِ And their abode will be fire. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنْصَارِ And these evildoers will find no helper. Now because God incarnate concept was mentioned before also, now the Trinity concept. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةٍ In the same way, and these words are implied, in the same way, those people have also committed blasphemy, they have also become kafir, unbelievers, who say that Allah is the third of the three, Trinity. وَمَا مِنْ إِلَٰهٍ إِلَّا إِلَٰهٌ وَاحِدٌ While there is no God except the only one God. Allah is the only one God. وَإِن لَمْ يَنْتَهُوا مَا يَقُولُونَ And if they don't give up what they are saying, if they don't desist, لَيَمَسَّنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ Very painful torment would come to them. أَفَلَا يَتُوبُونَ إِلَى اللَّهِ Don't they make repentance towards Allah? Don't they want to return to Allah? فَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَهُ And ask His forgiveness? وَاللَّهُ غَفُرُ الرَّحِيمُ Allah is forgiving, Allah is merciful. Repent, mend your ways, mend your beliefs, become muwahid, leave Trinity. And Allah, you will find Him. لَوَجَدُ اللَّهَ تَوَّابًا رَحِيمًا They would have found Allah that He is very much tawwab, who accepts tawbah of the bondsmen, of the servants of Allah. And He is Rahim. مَا الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ إِلَّا رَسُولُ Masih, son of Mary, was nothing but a messenger. وَقَدْ خَلَقْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُولُ And before him, so many messengers had come, had gone. If he was a messenger, Moses was also a messenger of Allah, Ibrahim was also a messenger of Allah, Nuh was also a messenger of Allah, Hud was also a messenger of Allah, Saleh was also a messenger of Allah. Shuaib was also a messenger of Allah. Lut was also a messenger of Allah. He was also a messenger of Allah. مَنْ مَسِيْهُ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ إِلَّا رَسُولُ قَدْ خَلَقْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُولُ وَهُمُّهُ صِدِّيقًا And his mother was among the most righteous. Siddiqa, this is the second degree from above. Third degree from below. فَأُولَٰئِكَ مَعَ الَّذِينَ عَنَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاءِ وَالصَّالِحِينَ The pious Muslims, virtuous Muslims, صالحين. A step upward, shuhada. Still higher up, siddiqeen. Topmost, anbiya. This nabuwah was never given to any woman. Because it entails a very heavy burden of responsibility. To be persecuted by the people. This risalah and nabuwah was reserved and had been reserved for men only. The topmost position to which a woman could reach is siddiq, siddiqa. In our ummah, as-siddiq al-akbar, Abu Bakr. As-siddiqat al-kubra. Khadija radiyallahu anha. Ummuhu Siddiqa. She was also not a part of Godhead. Must remember, you know, this Trinity. In the beginning, this was another Trinity. They included Mary also in Trinity, Godhead. Later they changed, excluded Mary, Maryam, alayhi salam, and included the ghost, the Holy Ghost, Ruhul Qudus. This Trinity has changed during the passage of time. Otherwise, Mary was also one of the three. God as Father, Jesus as Son of God, Mary as God Mother. And actually, this Trinity they borrowed from the Egyptians. When Christianity, you know, spread from Palestine towards Rome, now the passage was through Egypt. And in the ancient Egypt, they believed in a Trinity. God as Father, Horus, the Son of God, Isis, the God Mother. They had a Trinity. So the Christians also, they imitated them. And they invented Trinity into Islam. It was Islam. The religion of Jesus, alayhi salatu wasalam, was Islam. They introduced Trinity into Islam. And the first Trinity was God as Father, the Heavenly God, the Heavenly Father. Then Jesus, Son of God, and Mary, the God Mother. Later on, they excluded Mary. And now the Trinity is God as Father, Jesus, Son of God, and the Holy Ghost. That is why you will find that next ayah. وَالْمَسِيْهُ بْنُ مَرْيَمَ إِلَّا رَسُولُ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ وَأُمُّهُ صِدِّيقَةَ كَانَا يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. Both of them used to eat meals. Well, Allah doesn't need any meals. Neither Masih was God, nor Mary was God. كَانَا يَأْكُلَانَ الطَّعَامِ. So here the first form of Trinity is being discussed. أُنْذُرْ كَيْفَ نُبَيِّنُ لَهُمُ الْآيَاتِ ثُمَّ انْذُرْ أَنَّى يُؤْفَكُونَ. Look to it, how we are making the things clear to them, explaining everything. And then look again. Anna yufakun, where are they, where from they are being deluded away? After all these things having been cleared, then they are turning to the other side. قُلْ أَتَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَمْلِكُ لَكُمْ ضَرًّا وَلَا نَفْعًا. Ask them, do you want to worship besides Allah, who doesn't have any authority for you, neither of good or benefit, nor of any harm? فَاللَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. And Allah is all-hearing, all-knowing. قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لَا تَغْلُوا فِي دِينِكُمْ. Again the same word, غُلُوْ. Don't exaggerate. Don't exceed the limits. You love Jesus very well. You must love Him. But don't raise Him to the level of Godhead. O Muslims, you love Muhammad? It's very good, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You must love Him from the depths of your heart. You must love Him more than anybody else, except Allah. The Prophet said, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين. None of you can be a real Muslim, a mu'min, unless he loves me more than his father and his son and all the human beings. Love him, but don't raise him to the level of Godhead. لا تغلو في دينكم ولا غير الحق, which is not حق. ولا تتبعوا أهواء قوم قد ضلوا. Don't follow the wishes of a nation who had gone astray, the Egyptians. You have followed them. You have imitated them. قَدْ ضَلُّوا مِنْ قَبْلِ. They had gone astray before. وَضَلُّوا كَثِيرًا. And they have made so many to go astray. And وَضَلُّوا عَنْ سَوَاءِ السَّبِيلِ. And they had gone astray from the right path. Don't follow them. Don't imitate them. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing Iona is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about Iona, please visit us at www.tanzim.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.